Before I came here this morning, I was in the emergency room seeing patients. I still do not have a rapid diagnostic test available to me.
Well, that's easy to do, is it not? Is it hard to manufacture?
It is easy to do for some countries. What happened in the United States is that the CDC created a test.
Messed up a reagent.
Sent a test out to 50 states and then said, oh, hold up, don't use it, let us fix
it. How quickly
it's
can
now
we get
March.
On track now, man?
We hear that it's coming very soon, but I'm here to tell you right now, at one of the busiest hospitals in the country, I don't have it at my fingertips. I still have to call the Department of Health. I still have to make my case, plead to test people. This is not good. We know that there are 88 cases in the United States. There are going to be hundreds by middle of the week. There's going to be thousands by next week.
So
and this is a testing
people,
issue.
What do you do with people in the emergency room if you can't test them?
Well, we call and we try to test. We isolate them. We have an outstanding team of infection control practitioners who know how to handle this, but they're hamstrung by the fact that we don't have a diagnostic test available.
Are people getting sent home? Because I read reports of that over the weekend.
We're not sending people home. We're making sure they get what supportive care we can give. But keep in mind, we now have this in New York State, right? The person who tested positive was only the 32nd test we've done in this state. That is a national scandal. They're testing 10,000 a day in some countries, and we can't get this off the ground. I'm a practitioner on the firing line, and I don't have the tools to properly care for patients today. The message today is that we are hearing from this administration that the risk is low and that things are probably going to be okay. You don't need to change your lifestyle. That's simply not true. There are going to be thousands of cases here. We have already moved from containment to mitigation. We are trying to lessen the severity here. You are going to see widespread disruption to daily life. Do not believe the false reassurance.
So what does